Thank you all for coming to the Chamber of Commerce's annual holiday party. I'm Scott Richardson, President of the Chamber, and thank you again for coming. Tonight we have, I think, a great program. We have Ken Clark and Abby Rosenberg and others from the Sharon Timlin race to recognize and honor for their years of service and what they contribute to the community. We are going to take something a little bit out of order because Carolyn Dykema is here and she does need to leave sooner than our program allows. So we wanted to make accommodations for her because of everything that she does for our community. So we're going to have Caroline come up to make her presentations to Ken and to the Sharon Timlin teams, and then we'll eat, and then we'll resume with the program at 8 o'clock. So, Caroline.
Thank you, Scott. Thank you so much to the honorees and to everyone here for your flexibility in accommodating my family. My family is very grateful. I've got my children at home. My husband's out of town, so I was hoping to get home and feed them because they may not eat if I don't show up. But just happy holidays to everyone. I really love this event, and I want to recognize the Hopkinton Chamber, which continues to do such amazing work in this community and really in so many ways knit the commercial community and the business community in town with the rest of the community, and just leads to some really amazing, wonderful things. And so this is really a celebration of all of that and a celebration of individuals that also have played such strong roles in shaping the community over the years. And it's my pleasure and honor to be able to honor and recognize two of them here tonight. And I have official citations on behalf of both the House and the Senate. Senator Spilka sends her best wishes as well, and I have citations on her behalf. But the two people that are being recognized today are, I consider, friends and are very close to my heart in many ways, in addition to sort of my professional role, also to my personal role. And first I will recognize former Chief Ken Clark, who just, I really don't need to explain Ken's role in the community to so many here. One of the remarkable things, I think, about the role that Ken has played, in addition to his professional role as serving for fire chief for 44 years, is the fact that he's also of this community. And to have someone who grew up in this community, understand this community so well, and also be able to lead the fire department over the years, there's something really special about that. And I think the professional is reflected in the personal is reflected in the professional. And Hopkinton is just so fortunate to have someone like that, which is rare, having served this community and continuing, in fact, to serve this community. I still see him out on the street, you know, directing me into traffic and things, so Ken is still around. One of the stories that I thought I would share, because I think it really shows so much about a person, more so than maybe the headlines that folks may see. But I had the privilege of attending the retirement party for the chief and sitting at a table of the tech rescue team. And we were just talking casually. There were two gentlemen there who come from out of state, who come in state on a regular basis to train the tech rescue team in the fire department. And they see a lot of fire departments all over the country, and they're very well versed in very technical rescue expertise, which has become more and more important, especially in this world that we live in, especially post-2001. And I had the opportunity to hear just this casual commentary on the leadership role that our chief, Chief Clark, had played in really advancing the technical expertise that now is commonplace. But back before it was commonplace, when Hopkinton had the marathon, the chief had the wisdom and the foresight to recognize that more safety and security was needed than kind of was traditional. And he did that because he cared so much about the community and he knew that the community needed to be safe. And he, from what I understand, played a really leading role in the conversation that led to where we are in terms of technical rescue and safety at large public events. And I hadn't heard that before, and I don't know if many people in this room had heard that before, but he not only was a leader in this community, but was very much a leader in the fire community at large, not only the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, but also nationally. And it was really special to hear those stories at the table that night, and I wanted to make sure to share them with you here tonight. So if I could call Ken up and recognize him for everything he does. This citation on behalf of the Massachusetts House, and it reads, be it hereby known to all that the Massachusetts House of Representatives offers its sincerest congratulations to Kenneth Clark in recognition of receiving the Hopkinton Chamber of Commerce's 2016 Distinguished Service Award for your extraordinary contributions to the Hopkinton community. The entire membership extends its very best wishes and hope for future good fortune, and it's signed by Speaker Robert DeLeo and Carolyn Dykema, State Representative. So, Chief, to you, congratulations, and thanks for everything.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. One more.
There we go, this one. And also on behalf of Senator Spilka, a citation from the Senate.
Thank you very much.
And I understand that Abby is not here, is that right?
Coming later.
Correct.
On her way.
She's coming later from one of her son's basketball games later. So.
Family, we understand.
Yeah.
We understand family commitments.
So we do have a couple of stand-ins for accepting.
Excellent. Big shoes to fill, I will say, for the stand-ins. So Abby Rosenberg, I'm thrilled to be able to honor her again, because I was really glad to be able to help recognize her at the State House. I don't know if many of you know that she was recognized as being one of the 2014 unsung heroines of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. So she came in with a number of other women from across the Commonwealth to be recognized by the Massachusetts Commission on the Status of Women for her contributions to building community here in Massachusetts. So her contributions are widely recognized, and also locally recognized. So to be able to give her another recognition, again, someone who needs no introduction in this room, Abby has really been a force, most notably with the Timlin Road Race, which she started and nurtured into something that is really an institution here in Hopkinton. I remember when I was first running for office and I was getting to know the communities that I was running in, and seeing the big highway sign on the side of the road for the Timlin Road Race, and you know, not really knowing much about it, and now looking back and looking at how much it's grown even in that short period of time, is really a remarkable testament to Abby, really, and the team that she's formed around her. And I was just talking to Kelly Grill a few minutes ago. Where's Kelly? There she is. We were talking about Kelly and the work that she's done at the HCA, and I was speculating about the number of people who have an idea, which a lot of people have ideas, and a lot of them are great ideas. But what really sets people apart is their ability to take that idea and not only have the work ethic and the passion and the commitment, but also just the heart to take it from idea to fruition. And not only has Abby done that in spades, but she continues to do it every day. And so it's really a privilege and a pleasure to be able to recognize her. I wish she were here personally so I could share this with her, but if a designee could come up, and I hope you will pass along my best wishes to her when she comes later tonight. So on behalf of the Massachusetts Legislature, I will not read it again, but I will just honor Abby Rosenberg for receiving the Hopkinton Chamber of Commerce 2016 Distinguished Service Award for your extraordinary contributions to the Hopkinton community. So thank you for accepting on her behalf. And again, please give her my best wishes. And also on behalf of Senator Spilka. So thank you all again. Have a wonderful meal.
Again, thank you all for coming tonight. It's always a great time that we have here, and take the time to recognize and thank people for contributions they made to the community. I just wanted to chat real quick about several of the things that the Chamber has been up to this past year. One thing that hopefully everybody has seen and admired is the Gateway Green Project on West Main Street. So an incredible team effort. Peter Mezit spearheading. Where's Peter? There he is. The project wouldn't have happened without Peter. And then Finn Perry, unfortunately, I think couldn't make it at the last minute tonight. Again, between the two of them and a few other people, really pulled this together, got a lot of sponsors to step up to the plate, and obviously got it funded, got it constructed, and it looks fabulous. And I think the signs are look pretty good too. What does everybody think? So, great team effort, good improvement to the community. So over the past year, the Chamber's been part of, sponsored, and or participated in about 9 ribbon cuttings for new businesses here in town, which is pretty fantastic. And one thing we're very proud of, there's some on each table, is the community business and community guide that has had a very long gestation period. Eric, want to hold that up higher? So those are available. There's extra copies up front. Really the first edition of this, if you will, for really telling what the story about how great a town Hopkinton is to live in, to work in, and to play in. And we're always looking for suggestions how to improve it. We do have it available electronically on the Chamber website and on the town website. So again, any suggestions you have, we'll continue to make improvements to that. So those are some of the things we've been up to. And just wanted to, again, bring Tim Kilduff up to start some of the recognitions here. One other thing, the cakes that you've been enjoying have been made by Katie Connell over here. So she has spoiled us ever since the Gateway Green opening when she brought the first cake, and now of course we can't have an event without her providing fabulous cake. So thank you, Katie. So. Tim?
Thank you, Scott. When the board of directors sits around and tries to think about people and groups to recognize, it's a pretty thorough process, and sometimes not always obvious. But there are two running events that happen in Hopkinton. There's one the third Monday in April that you're probably familiar with. But then there's another road race that has become, and it's really safe to say, and I'm confident when I say this, one of the best road races in New England. And I want to tell you a little bit about the background and how it got to that point. And there are elements that go into making that such an successful event. About how many years ago now, 14, 15, 14 years ago, Abby Rosenberg, who was moved by the fact that she had a friend who was stricken with ALS, wanted to do something. And she thought about putting together a road race. And she went to a guy named Rich Kennedy. Rich Kennedy is the founder of something called the Angel Fund. The Angel Fund is an extremely successful nonprofit that raises money for ALS research. And most of that money, in fact, all of it goes into UMass Medical to a physician named Dr. Brown, who happens to be one of the most renowned ALS research people in the world. And that's not a stretch of anyone's imagination. This is a very, very committed, dedicated guy who's created a team, and it's just 10, 12 miles from us. But one of the things that that Rich said to Abby when she said, yeah, I like to do this road race, and I'd like to raise $50,000, $60,000, $70,000. I've actually heard Rich say this, you know, yeah, good for you, lady, but it ain't going to happen. If you raise $5,000 or $10,000, that'd be a big deal, because that's what road races raise. Particularly, everybody thinks, well, let's go do a road race, we'll raise a lot of money. It don't work that way. It ain't the Boston Marathon. It's not fraught with sponsors just lining up to do this. So she started out with a little bump, saying, well, I'm gonna keep going anyway. But one of the things that Abby did that's phenomenal is that she recruited a leadership team. They're on this list, and they'll be getting certificates tonight as well, but in recognition as well. But she began to attract really quality people, people that were committed to the cause, important issue in the success of any event, and committed to this concept of teamwork. I don't know if you've ever watched, you probably haven't seen, you see the results of the Timlin leadership team when they run this successful road race, but they really do work at this 12 months a year, and they're serious about it. But to start out with a road race that somebody tells you you're gonna raise $5,000-$10,000, and to end up 14 years later donating $1.5 million to this single cause is pretty phenomenal. And I don't know where that exists anywhere else. And that's what that team does. To put on the race, you know, the Boston Marathon talks about the 1,000, 1,500 volunteers for 37, 40,000 runners. The Timlin race has 200 volunteers that work on this race continuously. The 1.5 million is not reached by any other local road race that I know about. The number of runners they fill out, they sell the entries out very, very quickly. But to me, what drives this event is not only Abby and Dave Kruger's commitment to the cause, but the fact that they've been able to transfer that emotion to a group of leaders that put on this phenomenal road race. I can tell you, there is not another road race like this anywhere in this region and probably anywhere in New England that delivers the results. A lot of that goes to the heart and the passion of the person who founded it, the person who continues to stay involved in it. And I know every year I've heard her talk about stepping back for a minute and thinking about, well, maybe I should step aside. I don't think that's going to happen, and I don't think that leadership team is going to let her do that. But it's a privilege. It's a privilege on behalf of the Chamber Board of Directors to present not only to you, Abby, but certificates to your entire team, a Distinguished Service Award. The Hopkinton Chamber of Commerce Board of Directors is pleased to recognize the contributions made by Abby Rosenberg and this distinguished team to the heartwarming success of the Sharon Timlin 5K road race. While raising funds for ALS research, the event contributes to Hopkinton's reputation as a caring and generous community. Abby?
No, not yet.
Not yet.
But you can hold it.
But you won the game. Oh, don't leave.
Oh, we got another one. I'm a lot shorter than Tim is. You know, I travel all over the world, and people ask me where I'm from. And I say Hopkinton, Massachusetts. And they say, well, how far is that from Boston? And I say 26.2 miles. And they say, oh, that's where they start the Boston Marathon. You know, and we're known for the Boston Marathon. But the Boston Marathon only exists because we have thousands and thousands of volunteers. And that's the same thing with your race. It wouldn't exist without you and your leadership team and the hours and hours that you put into it, dedicated to this one cause. And to, like Tim was saying, that to be able to start from such a small seed and grow it to $1.5 million is just amazing. I was just speaking with Dawn, one of your leadership team, a minute ago, and she was saying that she does it because it's fun. And this is what volunteerism is all about, is, you know, dedicating a portion of your life to do something that's fun, and for this, it can actually save lives. So for what you do is just, it's you know, I consider it a privilege to be one of your selectmen, and it's such a privilege for me to be standing here saying to you thank you for all that you do to save so many lives and to give your group some fun while doing it. So on behalf of the Board of Selectmen, Abby, I'd like to present you with this citation. The Hopkinton Board of Selectmen are pleased to express their congratulations to Abby Rosenberg with this Distinguished Service Award as a member of the Sharon Timlin Road Race Leadership Team, as honored by the Hopkinton Chamber of Commerce for many years of service, signed on the hand of the seal of the 13th day of December 2016, Brian Hurd, Chairman, Todd Sestari, Claire Wright, John Catino, Vice Chairman, and Brendan Tedstone. Thank you. I consider it a privilege to give you this. Thank you very much.
Wow, thank you so much. So, sorry I'm late, we won the game. And so I just want to say that we are so delighted to be presented with this award. We have a lot of gratitude for the long-standing support of the town of Hopkinton, the many local businesses that support us, and the wonderful community of Hopkinton. Furthermore, to be honored alongside retired fire chief, our hero Ken Clark, who has helped us so much over the last 14 years with this event, is very humbling to us. So thank you. Coincidentally, our team has been discussing how to better engage the Hopkinton business community. So when we were told of this award, it was an affirmation that we're right on track, and we welcome the invaluable involvement of our business community, and we hope to continue expanding those relationships. Secondly, I want to acknowledge and thank the Timlin Event Leadership Committee. They've come together year after year to make this a fantastic, successful event. It's been a very interesting 14 years with a lot of growing pains, a lot of bumps and bruises along the way. But when all is said and done, we have donated over $1.5 million to fund the researchers that are working tirelessly to find a cure for ALS. The Timlin Event team is just really remarkable. And they all work together, we have fun, and put together an unbelievable event. So I hope that you guys all stick with it, because I'm not retiring yet. And lastly, I just want to tell you why we work so hard each year and why your support means so much to us. Many of us have been affected by ALS, either directly or indirectly. And we've met many families along our journey that have been impacted by the disease. Some of those families are right here in Hopkinton, and some travel very far to attend our event. And we've all been very touched by their stories. They've meant a lot to us. And as Tim said, I launched the event 14 years ago because my dear friend George, who was a young father and husband at the time, was diagnosed. And by some small miracle, he is still living with the disease. We are all just so touched and inspired by all of these people that are living or have lived with ALS. So we're on a mission to raise awareness and raise money toward finding a cure. We have good reason to hold on to the hope that a cure for ALS is around the corner because of the breakthroughs that are coming faster and faster every year. The disease merits our attention as a community, and I can't express deeply enough the gratitude and pride that I feel and that my fellow committee members feel about being here tonight. So thank you very much for this honor.
Where's Tim? Are you back up here again?
No, you're in charge.
I am?
President.
Oh, yeah, that's right. That's what it says. I'd like to have Bill Miller come up to say a few words, or as many words as you want. You probably have a few stories, like a couple hundred.
Yeah.
So, okay, great.
Thank you, sir.
Yep.
Good evening. Thank you. I don't even know where to start. So about 3 weeks ago, I met with Tim and Drew Cunnies and said, hey, we have this idea. We're honoring Kenny. We'd like you to do an opening speech for him. I was really excited, jumping up and down for joy. It was an honor. The last couple nights, I've been waking up at midnight going, what did I get myself into? What do I mean by that? Where do I start? I've been fortunate to be here for 17 years. This night's not about me, but it's about Kenny. And the last 17 years have been an honor and a pleasure to work with this gentleman. We could talk about stories all night long. Probably some of them shouldn't be aired here. And if you know Kenny, which most of you do, you probably know the backside of the stories anyways, no pun intended. So where do we go? How do we do it? In the last 17 years, I've never met a gentleman who knew more people, was more devoted to his community, had the heart, who breathed, bled, lived the town of Hopkinton and the Hillers. Someone who had pride and ownership in a very small community that is now growing very fast. Caroline Dykema mentioned something about training. Back when I was a little boy, many, many moons ago, my dad was in the fire service also. I remember coming to Hopkinton, watching my father train at Pine's Pit at the gas field. Kenny was one of the people who developed this. And for the longest time, it was the only program that was in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts that was training firefighters how to deal with natural gas or propane-fed fires. We didn't have any of this before. We do have it now. We have a state-of-the-art system at the academy. But it goes back to without Kenny and the Arthur Stewart days and the many people that put the time and effort into this, we wouldn't have it. So what are we saying? Gentleman gave us 44 years of his life away from his family. Marie, you know how that goes. It's a unique job. It's a unique business. You have to want to do it. Kenny wanted to do it. I'm sure he still wants to do it. He is still doing it, helping out and filling in. I can't tell you how much of an honor it is to be standing here tonight, to be able to give a little opening speech to Kenny, congratulate him, also thank him for 17 very good years that I've been here. Not every day was a good day. The bad days were we learned. There were days that we were both so mad at each other we wouldn't talk for a couple days, but then we'd go back and we'd shake hands. Or one of us, I would say, Chief, I was wrong. It was that type of relationship. It was that type of commitment that Kenny gave to the community and he still gives to the community. I could talk for hours. I know it's getting late and I understand that. So I'm not gonna talk for hours. But I wanna say, Chief, thank you. Thank you very much. At this time, I wanna invite Chief Slamin up and pass the microphone to Chief Slamin. There
you go, Chief. Thank you, sir. I can never miss an opportunity. So first off, I just want to say thank you for the group that, for Abby, the work you did, the Timlin race. I have a cousin that lost the battle of ALS, and it's just so awesome that the work you do and you do it in Hopkinton and you're part of our community. Thank you so much. So I hope as fire chief, I can kind of help you in the future. The second piece I guess I want to do is just build on community a little bit. I think the one story that hit me the most as a new chief and kind of realizing what Ken has passed along to me was I got invited over to the respite center and I got my tour and the kids would always come to the fire station and see me, but Ken was a little more mobile. Ken was in that building all the time, meeting the families, working with the kids. And the kind of the special story I got towards the end of the tour, they were talking to me about, okay, you have this new responsibility as fire chief. One of our kids now and then gets to the point where he's struggling so much that we literally, there's one person that will help us. And the phone call goes to Ken and he literally will leave his house and he'll come down. And that's how they're able to take care of this one child. And that's when I kind of realized the scope of, you know, his impact to the community, his dedication. You know, to say it's not just a job, he truly kind of exemplifies, you know, giving your life to the community and community service. So for that, I'm honored. I guess I get to read a certificate if I can find it, if I can see it, if I can see the words, because I'm, let me do my part here. So thanks. We'll see what it says. I can always make pretend.
Not that one.
Okay, so kind of representing the board and the chamber, and thank you for that opportunity. The Hopkinton Chamber of Commerce, Board of Directors is pleased to recognize the contributions made by Ken Clark. During his many years of service to the residents of Hopkinton, his commitment to his work helped make Hopkinton a safer place to live and to work. Thank you for your loyalty, dedication, and devotion. Thanks, Chief. Want to come up and down?
And John wants to say a few words, too.
Ken Clark. Commitment, loyalty, dedication, and devotion. For 44 years. Every resident of Hopkinton knew that they had the confidence that Kenny could put out a fire. Everybody could sleep at night knowing that they were safe. Just ask Selectman Hur. He saved his house there a little bit. You know, and for me, I know that Kenny could hire and train some great EMTs because on several occasions, saved my mother. And I totally appreciate that. And now with my position at the community at Golden Pond, I see the guys, I hate to say it sometimes on a daily basis, come in and very professional and take care of our residents and make sure that they're safe and get them to the hospital. And really, it's an honor and a privilege again. And from the entire Board of Selectmen, I wish to thank you from the bottom of our hearts for 44 great years of service. And I want to present you with this citation. Town of Hopkinton, we, the Hopkinton Board of Selectmen, are pleased to express congratulations to Kenneth Clark with the Distinguished Service Award, as he is honored by the Hopkinton Chamber of Commerce for his many years of service and dedication to the town of Hopkinton. Signed under our hand and seal of this 13th day of December, Brian Hur, Chairman, John Catino, Vice Chairman, Todd Sestari, Brendan Tedstone, and Claire Wright.
Chief,
thank you very much.
Thank you very much. I do that right? As everyone knows, this is my favorite part, standing in front of everybody talking. Thanks, Tim. But I'm not really sure where to start. But at 15 and a half, I went to the fire department to be a call volunteer. That's kind of like the gopher for the fire department when you're at that age. You went and got coffee, you went and got lunch, you rolled the hose, you hang the hose, all those things. But it starts to lay a foundation. And with my sports in Hopkinton, I learned at an early age what the definition of team was. When I went to the fire department, that was a natural form of the best team that I've ever been involved with. We have a lot of things here that we dealt with on a day-to-day basis that formed a bond between us that will be forever till the day I die. We'll always have a strong bond, all of us. And you share that. But the community was important to me, coming from a large family. Many generations, I think I was the third on the fire department, but the family goes back, the family tree's been back traced to 1888 when we came to Hopkinton. And it's a natural fit for me to move through the community, and I jumped at the chance to work with Abby and her team when they needed help to do the EMS section of their event the first year. And Stephanie would always come and wouldn't organize that. And we do a lot with the marathon, and it's almost a full-time job for somebody now. It's changed so much. So I started at 15 and a half, and then at 22, I went on the job full-time and spent like 38 years and a couple of months and retired last January. And Hopkinton to me is, you couldn't ask for a better community. I had a chance one time to go to Boston, and my chief at the time, Chief Stewart, was very well connected there. He said, you want to go? You're in? I said, my roots are in Hopkinton. When you cut me, I still bleed green, okay? And I stayed home where my roots were, and I never regretted it one minute. And it's like I've met a lot of great people on the road. I see Drew here. His name's been announced here. And I'm part of his CrossFit family. And we have a lot of fun there. And Mark's there. But my fire department family and my town family and with Norman's team at the town hall is always a very, very special place. And still, when I get a chance, I'll jump in there and say hi to those people when they're not busy at a meeting or something like that. But it's just about the community to me. And it was like, it was never, my first chief, who was fantastic, Chief Stewart, said to me, it's not about the individual, it's about the community first and then the organization. And it comes to that team thing. And it was always, and it was very easy for me to follow that lead. I had great mentors like Chief Stewart and his brother, Dick was the deputy, and the Pines, Artie and Fran, and Bobby and Jimmy Bartlett, Tippy Spinks, all those guys that mentor and just send you in the right direction down the street. And it's like, and I was very blessed to have all that help. And I always felt like I was truly that person. It takes a village to raise the boy. And it's like, and I really feel like that, the town of Hopkinton, and it still does, it still shows me the support for that. And I'm so appreciative of that. And I try to share that with my boys all the time. And I'm just proud to be recognized. I'm very humbled and proud to be recognized by the organization, because that's not why we do our job, you know. But it's nice to get the recognition when it comes. And I felt like I've overstayed my time here. I'm like, no, I'm not a good one, like, standing up and talking, you know what I mean? So it's like, from the bottom of my heart, thank you very much to your organization and to everybody here.
They've all
been so supportive all along. If I needed something, I could go to an EMC or anybody that was here for the fire department or the town, and people would say, what do you need? Just tell us and we'll help you. So it was a great, great ride. And it's like, it's fun to listen now. And every time I go by, I hear the air horns go on the truck, they go by the house, I get a little, like, you know, just to remind me, you know. So it's like, you know, today I stopped for lunch with them, and it was like, it was just like, time has never stopped.
Right.
So it's like, but thank you very much, for your support over the years, and it's fun just to say out in the street and say, shake someone's hand and say hi, and that's an important part of my life now, but thank you very much.
Thank you. Again, thank you, Ken, for coming by my house many years ago and putting out the little fire in our bathroom. I'm sure everybody probably has a similar story. So, again, thank you all for coming. Great evening. It's wonderful to be able to have these types of people that we can thank in our community for making our community a better place to live. So, again, enjoy. There's still actually lots of cake up here, and it's got to get eaten. So, again, thank you all for coming.